again, and I fell in love right then. Oh, I was told she was promised to John. I followed her in a store, and I loved her even more, though I knew she was promised to John. Someplace where we can talk. Yes, I know that you promised to John. You won't hurt anyone. We'll just have a little fun. 'Cause I know that you promised to John. We walked behind a tree, and she gave her lips to me, even though she was promised to John. I guess she's with him now, she should be anyhow, 'cause she said she was promised to John.
I'm promised to John.
Harbor hurt or hide our cares so needlessly. Take it from me, I mean, no sweeter bride has ever been, and all the world would share their love with you. In the distance, looking back, there would have been a time or two when the world would seem to put itself between myself and you. Good friends would always overlook, 'cause fondness has its way, and the love that brings us ever close is the reason why I say you will be mine, all mine, and let's never waste our time to harbor hurt or hide our cares so needlessly. Take it from me, I mean, no sweeter bride has ever been, and all the world would share their love with you. As we look into the future, with the love I know will last, we'll be friends to one another, and just let the world go past. We'll share with friends and neighbors the little things in life, and I'll always be so glad to know I'm glad that you're my wife. You will be mine, all mine, and let's never waste our time to harbor hurt
Michael Collins. Michael Collins.
Singing a very appropriate song for tonight, isn't it?
That's right.
For to start off.
That's right, and he's going with an Cult here as well at the moment.
Oh, and there's more,
he's
isn't
on,
there
he's
about...
on as we speak on RT, well, TG Carr, actually.
Oh.
But I think he's hanging on there for another week.
And of course, Sean, it's very relevant to something that's happening in May.
That's right. All roads lead back to Star Trek on Sunday the 25th of May, where Michael Collins is going to be doing an open-air concert.
Wow.
So right. Mick Fitzgerald is hoping for a fine day on
we'll
the
be all praying. We'll be all praying for fine weather for Mick.
And dear viewers, of course, you're very welcome to programme 238. Absolutely. The 18th programme
we
of
had
our,
to check it out to believe that we've come so far.
That's true.
We
indeed.
Couldn't believe it.
And we have only three more weeks to go, folks.
That's right.
We go on our summer holiday.
Three
that
more little programmes
three
to
more.
Go.
So, Sean is editing this week's programme.
That's right.
And then the other three editors will have the final three programmes to edit.
I'm officially on holidays from...
And that's it? And that's it for another season.
Now, Sean, you have a very important notice to mention there relating to Corriginema.
Well,
your beloved Corriginema, hold it up there and everybody see it.
Even Sean Redley, we're doing it here in the studio. We're kind of going on fruit and all this thing. Corrigan, we're going on fresh food.
Ah.
We're in a wide zoom in this year.
Yeah.
And we can try and read it.
Our we'll all help.
Good. We'll have to go in close, so that's the job.
Fresh food 2014.
Fresh food 2014. I don't know. Sean Redley, if we were glasses
it's by
on
the Carrigan
Association.
Yes,
indeed. April and the Riverside Park Hotel in Macroom.
Indeed.
Which chef, where is he down there?
Moynihan.
There we have
Chef Frank Moynihan. And it'll be starting at 8 o'clock.
Sharp.
And the
exactly.
admission is €10 and you're told
tickets
to come early and bring a friend.
And tickets are available from members of the Parents Association. Our telephone 087-93-44-174.
Oh, thank God for all I said. And already they thank you for your great support.
Yeah, so we'll remind you about that again next week.
So now.
And you mentioned there, of course, John, our emphasis on fruit here. But of course, you notice that we have lots of different fruits there, but there is one fruit missing. What
That's
is
right.
missing?
I wonder, yeah. Well, which answers? Would
which fruit is missing?
Us in? Zoom in there. I'll give them my number
it's
there.
It's a beautiful ball of fruit anyway. And to get on with the programme, the banana is missing. The banana is missing.
Ida, you were not supposed to say that. We were going to do it as a competition.
Oh!
But so the competition is now cancelled because Ida said the banana is missing. And why is the banana missing?
They're telling me nothing here. They're telling me nothing.
Why is
the banana missing?
But why do we not have a banana there?
Can I say it now?
Do,
I won't be leaving any of the cat out of the bag.
Please do.
Because the banana tends to rot the rest of the food, decays the rest of the food.
So one is always meant to keep bananas separate from the other
fruits.
And in that way then, absolutely.
Strange
now,
to say.
We have a very special
and I got a hint. I got a hint the other day on how to keep mushrooms fresh. If you know the way they can go off sweaty and they're kind of in the bag or in the fridge, put them into an egg packer. Put them into an egg packer and keep them lovely and dry and fresh inside the egg packer. That's the end of our house outings for the season.
I think the gang in Carrigan will want to take you out on the 23rd of April. Am I right, my dear? Yeah, Wednesday 23rd.
Get it right, the 23rd of April in Macro.
And we'd some great feedback, of course, to our reference to the John McCormack box set. Now, in next week's programme, we'll actually be showing you about the actual launch itself of the box set itself that took place in Cork in the Maryborough House Hotel. But that's going to be next week itself. But
what have you now?
You may recall that in this week's Lee Valley Outlook, you had a very, very special ad there in the back referring to a book launch. And there's the book launch being mentioned there about the memoirs of an old warrior. And it was absolutely fascinating because this, in fact, is the book itself, which was launched in the Riverside Park Hotel in Macroom last Saturday night. And my goodness, what an enormous crowd. It was fascinating altogether. Now, just some of the people that signed the book itself, you can see there that The man himself, Donal O'Hara, is right there on top, the man that actually has written the book itself, compiled and edited the book. And the book, of course, relates to Jamie Moynihan's fight for Irish freedom, 1916 to 1923. Now, the next person you notice there, we have mentioned here, is Éamon O'Caoimh. And Éamon O'Caoimh was the man that launched the book itself.
My goodness.
Another person here is Andreas O'Muinicón. And Andreas was the MC for the night and did an absolutely excellent job there, and gave a wonderfully, wonderfully inspiring speech, as did all of them, all of the different people. And the other person here is Donal O'Muinicón, Donal Moynihan himself, who signed here. And at the very back here, we had another man that signed, who gave a wonderful song there, the one and only Sean O'Shea. And Sean gave a wonderful song. Now, in next week's programme, we're going to have some highlights from the launch itself. There was an enormous crowd there. And they even had a piper to welcome people.
Yeah.
And I arrived way ahead of time.
You! Can we believe that?
No, it's usually the other way around.
Can we believe
it? What was very interesting is that many of the people that were present, they were related to many of the people mentioned in the book itself.
Great.
So an awful lot more about that we'll be telling you about next week on our programme itself. But what an amazing launch.
And of course, Sean, we mustn't forget, next weekend is All Walking in Mill Street.
All Walking.
It is indeed, yes, we have all the details here. I'll be mentioning later in my news. And this two-day walking festival in Mill Street on the 12th and the 13th.
Saturday and Sunday.
And there will be 3 walks per day. And there'll be people before you and behind you and everywhere for to take care of you during your walks.
Yeah.
So it's all there. And I'll be giving you out the contact number later on.
Yeah, excellent. And in fact, we hope to have a number of people from the Retired Teachers Association of Cork who hope to be joining on the 2 different days.
Very good.
Different walks itself.
There's a lot of emphasis on history. You know, it seemed to be this year, is it the 1000th anniversary of the Battle of Clontarf, you know? And an awful lot of historical events are being unearthed.
And that'll all take place on Holy Saturday. It's on the Brandy Road.
The Brandy, it's kind of off the Butter Road. Up in Oban, kind of off the Butter Road.
Near enough to the Kerryman's
Table. It'll be signposted beyond the Kerryman's Table.
And
if you go out from Mill Street, it's beyond the Kerryman's Table.
There was a superb radio documentary on C103 by John Green Sunday.
Yes, there was.
And giving a complete insight into
the... amazing. People probably don't realise that they had people fighting and everything. Did you hear the people fighting in the background?
Yes.
I don't think there was anyone fighting up in the morning last week.
Sound effects, I think.
But do you know what I think?
I'll talk you sound effects. Wasn't there a lot of sound effects on RT last Sunday night?
Oh my
goodness. We're a lot better here on LTV too. There's no plates being dropped or spoons being popped off plates. And
I thought that was terrible.
It was on the radio
The awards
last few days.
Well, we have a very quiet studio here.
Have you news for us this week, Eileen?
I have, but what I was just going to say there, like the Rock now, where they're unveiling the memorial to King Mahon, which I'll be mentioning.
Yes.
You know, that rock was known as Mahon's Rock.
Indeed.
You know, and isn't it wonderful the way people hold on to these names down the years?
Yeah.
Long in 1993, was it, when the boat was found in Cumatrush Lake? And it was found in a spot that was known as the Boat Rock. And it's wonderful where people hold on to the old name. I think it's terribly important that if people do know of old names like that, to hold on to them. Because after a while, it might mean, it might be very significant in years to come.
Yes.
So that's what the bottle is.
Now, the old things, we were just talking before we started the programme tonight about a song. I said that the song we had from Michael Collins was called Eileen. You have your own version of Eileen.
Well, I don't know. I was waiting on like here.
I'll catch you on the spot. We'll just sing a verse of it. You were practicing there before.
Is this a nod to myself? A song to myself?
Yeah.
The one I know anyway is in a town by the sea near the Castle Doneen, the fairest of all was the maiden Eileen. The bloom on her cheek was as fresh as the dew, and her heart to a young fisher lady was true. That's the verse.
Right.
Is that the one?
Well,
is that the one?
Very, very good altogether.
So we have our own singing newsreader.
There you are now.
Exactly. This is
and you know, I think I should sing the news altogether. I'll make a song of it
we'll
to be more enjoyable.
Going to sing
yeah.
The news.
Yes, indeed.
Now, what else have you there?
So now, well, actually, we did refer last week to the music fair, and I was just presenting you all with a little memento.
Yes, indeed.
And that was, there were two music fairs in Mill Street. One was in 1996, and this is the one in 1997. And the one in 1997, it had such people as Christy Moore, Divine Comedy. Jules Holland, a huge lot of other people.
Why am I looking at yours and I have one on my own?
Francis Black. Yep.
They were all there. Absolutely. But that was a very special, and if you wanted tickets at that time, a two-day ticket was 30 pounds at the time, 30 pounds.
They were huge events,
yes.
Do you remember that the stages used to be all over the Green Glens?
Yes,
they
absolutely.
Were lovely.
So now we're ready, I think, for regional news.
All right.
On programme 238.
238.
Here we go.
Dis Maria Galeracada and welcome to LTV2 News. The AGM of the Lotto Committee was held at the Wallace Arms Hotel on Friday night. It was very well attended, and the fact that our Lotto has been running successfully for the past 20 years, it was an occasion for great joy and celebration. Co-chairman Councillor Noel Buckley and Dennis Toomey presided, and supported in no small way by Marie Toomey, Secretary. It was great to learn that since its inception, the Lotto has raised in excess of €1 million for Mill Street. And every cent of that has been ploughed back into the community through the town park, the community council for the youth amenities, and also for the GA in later years. Accountability being the key word all the way. People who contributed to the Lotto since day one were helped by it in their own young days. They saw their children getting the benefit of it, and now they're watching their grandchildren being helped by it. It's hard to put a name on that kind of dedication. On behalf of the group, Marie Toomey sincerely thanked the general public for their continued support. It was a combined effort, and everybody complimented everybody else on the night. At the election of officers, the committee was re-elected in block. Then a fine buffet meal was served by the Wallace Arms Hotel, and a great social evening followed. Copies of the financial report can be had from any member. The weekly lotto draw was held at Cockery's Bar on Sunday night. Numbers drawn were 1, 11, 23 and 28, and the jackpot was not won. €100 went to Lane and Edmund Fitzgerald Ratmore. The seller was Tommy Tucker, and he got €50 seller's prize. €50 went to Conor Connor Ratroo. 20 each to Peggy O'Keefe Minor O. Tom Cockery Knocknagallon. Margaret Healy Minor O. Jerry Reardon, The Mill Wheel Restaurant, Kathleen Kelleher, Drum the Hiller, Helen Murphy, Clara Road, Owen Guiney, care of Donald, and Angela McAuliffe from Mount Leader. Jackpot for next week is 9,400, and the draw will be at the Malpaso Bar on Sunday night. The AGM of the Turf Co-op was held at the Cannon O'Donovan Centre on Wednesday night. Another success story. Since it was formed by a dedicated few over 30 years ago, over all those years, hundreds of homeowners have had trouble-free turf all the way, thanks to great or excellent organising and to modern machinery. Orders for the coming season were taken at the AGM, and they were opened as usual. There were even more than in previous years. Cutting will begin as soon as possible. A highly successful fellicule was held on Sunday at the community school with lots of winners of various ages. Look up the website for all the pictures and all the other details. This is Hearing Awareness Week, and the powers that be are very worried about the state of people's hearing in view of today's noisy world, and are advising people to take great care, as it is a serious issue. We have a very full programme in the run-up to Easter. The Pony Show at the Green Glens this weekend, April the 12th and the 13th, and again on the 17th to the 20th. Our Walks Committee will hold a two-day hill walking festival on the 12th and the 13th. There will be three walks per day, and the contact number there is 086-380-9424. On Holy Saturday, April the 19th, a monument will be unveiled at Finan Field, Kilcorne, to King Mahon, brother of King of Brian Boru, who was slain there over 1,000 years ago. Ever since then, a simple stone at the roadside was known as Mahon's Rock. And well done to those who kept this historic feature alive until now. The place will be signposted off the Butter Road, and the ceremony will take place at 2 p.m. and all are welcome. The Easter Sunday, Mill Street Monument Committee will host their annual commemoration at the monument in the town square at 12:30. The oration will be given by popular local historian Jack Lane. The Community Council 5 mile fun walk in aid of AstroTurf Fund on Easter Sunday, the 21st of April. Registration at Kilmeady Castle at 11 o'clock. Light refreshments will be held on their journey's end. There's a blood donor clinic was held in the town during the week, and it was very well supported. The AGM of the Mill Street Town Park will be held tomorrow, Friday night, April the 11th, starting at 8:30. It will be held at the Canon O'Donovan Centre. The Community Council have placed notices in all our graveyards, asking people not to leave litter thrown around there and to show more respect for our late loved ones. Out in Cullen, they're having a 12-week weight loss programme, and the contact number there is Orla O'Connor, 086-062-3919. That's 086-062-3919. Mill Street Community Gym is up and running now and well looked after by Jennifer Collins. And the opening hours are Monday from 9 a.m. to 12, Tuesday 9 to 12 and 6 to 10. On Wednesday 7:30 to 12, 7:30 imagine in the morning to 12 and from 6 in the evening to 10. Thursday from 7:30 to 12, on Friday from 9 until 12 and from the evening from 5 until 10. And on Saturdays from 9 until 12 and 2 until 6. So those times should suit everybody. There's a notice here, the Disabled Drivers Association will hold their annual church gate collection before all masses at the weekend on Saturday the 12th and Sunday the 13th in Mill Street Ballydaly in Cullen, and your support would be very much appreciated. Music in the pub in Carriganimmer this weekend, this Saturday night, will be by the renowned Back on Track. Now back to the rest of the programme, and we are going back now to the launch, to Killarney, to the launch of a CD by Peter Lane back in 2006.
I've got heartaches by the number, troubles by the score. Every day you love me less, each day I love you more. I've got heartaches by the number, and the world that I can win. But the day that I stop counting, that's the day my world will end. Heartache number one, when you left me, I never thought that I could hurt this way. Heartache number two, you came back again. You came back but never meant to stay. I've got heartaches by the number, troubles by the score. Every day you love me less, each day I love you more. I've got heartaches by the number, and the world that I can win. But the day that I stop counting, that's the day my world will end. When you called me, you said you were coming back to stay. With hopeful heart I waited for you. Knock on my door, I waited up, but you must last your way. I got heartaches by the number, troubles by the score. Every day you love me less, each day I love you more. I got heartaches by the number, and the word that I can win. But the day that I stop counting, that's the day my world will end.
The songs will be on here. Kisses for Dummies. We'd do school and play side by side. I longed for the day that I could ask her if she could be my bride. I'd pick some wild mountain flowers for Mary. I told her I loved her today, but she said we never could marry. That her daddy died when she was very young. She never knew love from a man. I tried hard to show her that I loved her. I tried to make her mother understand. I picked some wild mountain flowers for Mary. I told her I loved her today, but she said we never could marry. My days of youth are gone and I am happy that my time's not very far away. I picked some wild mountain flowers for Mary. I placed them on her grave today. I picked some wild mountain flowers for Mary. I told her I loved her today, but she said we never could marry. That her mother would stand.
have it that you take a short little break. I'm going to be...
from Patrick O'Sullivan at Peter Lane's lunch, and
seems to be a very good night today.
Yeah.
Well, what's the happening this week?
The printed.
Yeah.
Nicky Rooney died at the weekend.
Oh yes. Yes. Was he in silent films or was he what?
He was mostly, I think, with Judy Garland and Boys Town and that sort
of thing. Oh, that's right. I remember that.
He would have been. Yeah. You would have seen him in the West End cinema.
He was good at playing convict, wasn't he?
He was. And
yeah. Yeah.
But see, this ball, he was playing the little boy, and he was
30
and
40
years.
Yeah. Well, I remember him. I should be started to go to the cinema there in the West End, like, it was a great place to go. Sixpence to go in there.
And what was it downstairs cheaper?
The downstairs was cheaper, because I'd say it would be double upstairs, like.
Yeah.
But the thing about the downstairs, it would go nearer to the screen, like, you know what I mean? The big tough tarts, they were very good when they'd be far away from the screen, do you know what I mean? Like,
right.
But downstairs for sixpence would be nearly up against it. Very good.
The seats were quite small, actually.
They weren't too bad, too.
You wouldn't stretch your legs too far inside.
We were small anyway, we hadn't to worry about it. Do you know what I mean?
And who used to work in the cinema?
There were several different people working there. You see, usually the fella that was serving their time, they'd be the ticket takers at the door going, as you know, the men that are under this, and Dennis Mack, he was the building contractor.
Yeah.
At any one stage, he might have five or six apprentices, carpenter apprentices, and they'd all have their turns there at the door different nights to collect the ticket.
A tanker job
at that.
Was it?
Yeah. And that would be their job, like. Then the ticket seller would be inside a little coop there.
Yeah,
the first thing we'd have to go into the door was a little shop to buy a bar of chocolate or a boy, but I wouldn't want
there. There was a small little, it was only a small, it's about smaller than the table, I think.
Yes, something like that, like, but you could get your chocolate, whatever you want there. Then when you go in further, then you buy your ticket to go in.
Yeah.
And when you would get your ticket there, you go in about three or four more steps and someone collects half it and give it to you. And the half ticket was very important because as we fell go around that time and raid the cinemas to see did you get your half ticket in case that the ticket wouldn't be registered for whatever they should get out of them.
So that I often wonder why people...
Oh, that was very important, eh?
Yeah, that the inspector...
That you wouldn't be using the ticket again the next night, you see. The ticket would have to be halved and some fella would come out there maybe every so often and he'd check a dozen people around
the cinema. It was fairly secure, it wouldn't be in there for that here.
You see it was blocked off on one side and the graveyard was on the other side. You know yourself, it was middle side and the graveyard. Like.
Who used to, women used to sell the tickets then?
Oh, there's been different women. Well, there was one particular woman that I say she was nearly selling tickets all the time.
Yeah.
She was a Bridie Fitz girl that she went to America after. But I say she was nearly the ticket woman all the time. There could have been changes with the women in the shop, all right. But she was there for a hell of a long time anyway. While I was doing for her, she was inside in that office selling tickets and you would have to have 6 months of the food, didn't you, or about in the story.
There's be fellows there with flash lamps and showing people seats. And
well, they were the apprentices, you see. They were the ticket takers.
Yeah.
So, when you would come in late and the lights would get off, the picture would be on, they'd show you where with their lamp, where to sit down and this and that. And then the back seats and up the high there. The men and women in the back seats just be up to no good there. A lot of them didn't go watching the picture.
They say that, all right.
Oh, definitely. There's no doubt about it.
Yeah. But you know, wasn't it amazing that there'd be so many people into films?
There was big crowds in them films. There was not a where to go.
Yeah.
Then the dance hall just started, you see, and they took the... Well, there was a top.
The TV killed
it off.
So Mickey Rooney won't be seen
in the
West End cinema anymore.
If he will, he'll be dead man.
Yeah. So tonight, I think, Brendan, you have Skeena Scholars.
Skeena Scholars. We're going back about 20 years tonight. And I'm sure now that a lot of these faces that will be in this, they're scattered everywhere. It's nearly all boys that are in this now. It's the boys' school that won that event, and I'd say there's a big scatter of people out of this. So after that then there's a small clip of Corpus Christi the same year, about 20 years ago, and there's a good share of your faces and young girls and young boys in this too, so watch out.
His name.
Ladies and gentlemen, somebody said his name.
Be Jesus the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God in his angels and in his saints.
Thank you.
I'm a tune of the people.
Well, my goodness, bygone days there, and what a precious footage that is. And because many of those faces there, as Brendan and Jerry said, many of those people are in different parts of the world at this point. They are the diaspora of Ireland in many, many ways there. So certainly I hope people found that hugely interesting there itself. Well, now we're going to go to another very, very interesting sequence there. By the way, the gentlemen were talking about the cinema there. And in fact, it opened in 1937. And if you reverse 37, it shut in 1973. Opened, and the very first film was One Night of Love, starring Miss Grace Moore. That was, and we actually have a recording of that that was on Channel 4 some years ago. So very, very, just an extra little piece of information there. Right, oh yes, and they're going to be telling you about, there was one very special free night at the cinema, but I'll let the lads tell you about that next week, because it's very, very interesting to hear about that. Now, we're now going to go to a very, very, very well-made video coming up here now by a gentleman called Kevin O'Keefe, the brother of Patrick O'Keefe in Cullen. And it's beautifully made there, and it refers to Cullen's special needs, Cullen and District Special Needs Association, and the threshing event in Cullen there in 2012. It's really very well made, so enjoy this.
next one.
Well, I think you'll agree that was an exquisitely and superbly made video there by our very good friend Kevin O'Keefe. And thank you very much, Patrick. Patrick and Myra O'Keefe and Colin for sharing that superb video. Well, now, our man on camera at the moment and the editor of this week, Mr. Sean Murphy, has acquired from Mr. John Kelleher. Am I right, John? Sean? Yes. Mr. John Kelleher from the Musgrave region has provided us with an excellent DVD which shows the modern version of what we just saw happening there. This is the modern version. And you can also access it on, and the lasses have to go on for this, on youtube.com. And it's Jack Kerry 1 is also mentioned in it, but this will appear actually on screen itself. So now, enjoy the modern version of, I suppose, really what happens on a farm there.
You may talk about Atlantis, how it's lost beneath the sea, the grave of the unknown soldier, or the cry of the old banshee. Who was the man in the iron mask? Was Jack the Ripper set free? But ask them always, Donegal, and it's still a mystery. If I could, I'd build a wall around old Donegal. The north, south, keep them out, by God, I'd build it all. See no chicken ranches, I'd legalize them all. We have our own Las Vegas in the hills of Donegal. Yeah, Las Vegas in the hills of Donegal. Clubs and all the pubs, blackjack and roulette. Neil Blaney, Bridge of Nathan, Mike Tyson, Benny Bell. In a show that can be known for its multi-millionaires, where Donald Trump would like a chunk and play them solitaire. If I could, I'd build a wall around old Donegal. The north, south, keep them out, by God, I'd build it all. Chicken ranches, I'd legalize them all. We have our own Las Vegas in the hills of Toledo. Yeah, Las Vegas in the hills of Toledo. To stand on top of Erebo would give me such a thrill. I'm here to say in Dublin there's gold within their hills. Fear of the safety, dear, the answer is free. There's a wall that's deep, the floor seems all empty. If I could, I'd build a wall around old Donegal. The north, south, keep an unbloody wall at the top. See no chicken ranches, I'd legalize them all. We have our own Las Vegas in the hills of Donegal. Yeah, Las Vegas in the hills of Donegal.
That's the way it is done now.
Yes, indeed. And thanks to John Kelleher for making available that excellent footage.
Big change in the tractor anyway. The
tractor and the halves that are a good bit bigger.
And if you remember in the wonderful, wonderful St. Patrick's Day parade in Corrigan and in Mill Street, the huge amounts of machinery that we saw there.
All the machinery, yeah.
And even apparently the turf cutting machine this year is cutting a bit wider. It's cutting a bit wider, so the machinery is getting bigger all the time. Yeah,
my goodness.
So
that's very interesting.
Turf this year.
No, I've given up the turf long ago.
And
even though I used to love it.
We noticed that our cameraman has something to say in the background here.
It's not that it's cutting wider, it's cutting
5 stands instead of 4.
That's what I mean. That the bite is
so
wider.
So 5 stands instead of four are being cut instead.
This year.
That's Brendan has indicated there the background there. So Brendan, could you come over here one moment? We'll have to show.
Let the camera run itself.
Come right around here for a moment.
Brendan is...
he's on automatic pilot.
Off duty now.
Right, Brendan, we better leave Brendan on camera. So. Yeah. Right you are. So, now, you'll remember, yes, well now, Sean, you're editing a mighty programme.
You're at the helm this week, Sean.
My job is nearly done for this season. I can relax now for the next 3 weeks.
That's right. And Sean, will you be on the walking festival?
I'll be looking at them.
And talking about looking at the, Brendan on camera has just been, this is what we were just about to say there, Brendan is just indicating that we are going to be covering the walk starting from Kilmeady, isn't it?
That's right.
Riley? And that will be on
Easter Monday.
At 11 a.m.
And it'll be passing your old ancestral home.
In Adraville.
And this is a first now because we'd never taken done a sponsored walk on this route before.
Oh, wow.
People can do all of it or a little of it or whatever they like.
Yes, yes.
And it's
a grand walk when you're going downhill.
But but what I would like to say, I would like to stress that it would not be suitable for, you know, for go-karts, that for buggies. People would be told not to bring, but it wouldn't be a suitable walk for people with buggies.
Right.
That's very important.
Yeah, I myself have travelled that road several times.
We'll
have assistance. Brendan will be there with his mobile assistance there, his wonderful vehicle that if anyone has difficulty in completing it or wants to take a rest, they'll be able to... help as such.
Well, I think to climb the few hills is the main thing. Like if you've got a hand climbing the hills, you'll be brilliant at falling around.
Well, right.
The easiest way to climb, to do that walk, is to start low, or just go in Ballinathone across, leave the castle and go down to Kilmeady Bridge and up the main road and in Ballinathone across. And it's pretty level there all along. So that when you'll come to the top of Kilmeady, it's downhill all the way there.
Do you know something, it is actually harder to go downhill than uphill. When you're after doing that sort of walk.
Right. Yeah, I suppose it is, I don't know.
We talked about the cutting of turf, but the cutting of logs is a factor that we've become... aware of there during the week also.
But all the fallen trees.
But not just that, there's going to be a very special fundraising event that we'll hear a lot more about before the end of our series. And a lot of it has to do, the prize, one of the prizes, will be a wonderful trailer load of blocks.
Oh, tell me how it is done and I will go off and try and win a trailer load of blocks.
Well, it's going to be in aid of Marymount Hospice, but we'll hear a lot more about the details of this at a future
point. That's very interesting.
Absolutely. And we'll have a lot more also on millstreet.ie because Sean checks millstreet.ie every day, Sean?
2 or 3 times a day.
Oh, well.
Oh, we all do. Everybody. Well, no, I think we are getting the word.
I was one of the people last week, the 1st of April, that logged on to the McDonald's website.
I must say I was one of them, sorry.
Oh, yeah, that there was a McDonald's opening in the square in Mill Street.
Yes. It looked very authentic. It really looked authentic, but it wasn't to be.
And Michael put up there for the 300 people that logged on to the McDonald's website, Happy Foods Day or whatever.
Well, Michael did a very, very good job there.
Well, it was a bit of a light-hearted thing anyway for Foods Day.
Yep. Indeed.
Yep. Anything
and now,
to make
Sean,
us
tell us...
That's it for this week, isn't
yes,
it?
Yes, and next week, of course, we'll have a lot of little mini
bits and
snippets.
Pieces, yeah.
Because it's the last
summing
time
up.
I'll be doing the editing for this season, I'll have to try and incorporate a lot of things, but briefly. Yeah. So, and now, Sean...
I think Willie goes out with Big Tom. I think we go for Richie Kavanagh. What do you think?
It's very good.
Just like a thing you
excellent.
Would do. Thank you, Sean, for all the editing and
indeed.
You did lovely programme.
Here we go over to Richie Kavanagh.
Stairwater Johnny, Johnny, Stairwater Johnny. Stairwater Johnny, Johnny, Stairwater Johnny.
I am
I'm a rally driver on the circuit for years. I'm a waffle man now for jamming gears. I revs around the corner, smash out some distress. I beat the garden man, buys the crack in disgrace.
Stay water, Johnny, Johnny, stay water, Johnny.
The car that I drive is an old escort. I bought it in Galway in the town of Gart. Brought her home and I stripped her down. Now she's one of the greatest old cars around.
Stay water, Johnny, Johnny, stay water, Johnny.
I am a rally driver on the circuit for years. I'm a waffle man now for jamming gears. You should see me doing a 100 turn. I'm the man to make the tires burn. Like I never did drive before. I had me foot flat on the floor. I'm going quite well in the rally so far. 3 seconds behind the leading car.
Stay water, Johnny, Johnny, stay water, Johnny.
Richie is always the pace notes man, shouting the mouse as loud as he can. Over a crest down 110, a flat 3 left and a crest again.
Stay water, Johnny, Johnny, stay water, Johnny.
I am a rally driver on the circuit for years. I'm a waffle man now for jamming gears. You should see me doing a 100 turn. I'm the man to make the tires burn.
Stay water, Johnny, Johnny, stay water, Johnny. Stay water, Johnny, Johnny, stay water, Johnny.
Stay water, Johnny. That's right, that's the truth. Driver straight sideways, lad. Was making me nervous, so I headed on back now for the service. Down along the bog road, now I was tipping, then the bloody owl clutch had started slipping.
Stay water, Johnny, Johnny, stay water, Johnny.
I am a rally driver on the circuit for years. I'm a waffle man now for jamming gears. You should see me doing a 100 turn. I'm the man to make the tires burn. Driver on the circuit for years. I'm a waffle man now for jamming gears. You should see me doing a 100 turn. I'm the man to make the tires burn.
Stay water, Johnny, Johnny, stay water, Johnny. Stay water, Johnny, Johnny, stay water, Johnny. Stay water, Johnny, Johnny, stay water, Johnny. Stay water, Johnny, Johnny, stay water, Johnny.
I saw her in the square, and I fell in love right there.